Hello friends, today we are going to learn about how to digitize and create and edit layer, a vector layer in QGIS. So this video will contain creation and editing of point, line and polygon. So in order to create any point, line or polygon, we should have a reference data set, and that reference data set can any be a georeference topo sheet or Google Earth image or any satellite image. So in our case, we will going to open our topo sheet. So we have a topo sheet of Bhopal city in Madhya Pradesh, India. In order to open a topo sheet, we'll click on layer, add layer, add raster layer. I've already copied my path. My topo sheet is in GeoTIFF format. So I will click filter my data site to GeoTIFF and open my Bhopal mosaic topo sheet. So this is a topo sheet of Bhopal city. First of all, we need to check that this topo sheet is correctly a georeference or not. In order to do that, we can overlay a Google Earth image in our QGIS. And how to do that, please refer to my older video with the help of HCM GIS plugin. This is a Google map. As we can see that my Google map of Bhopal city and upper lake is correctly overlaying my topo sheet. So I did not need the very first step to create a point file is to first of all create a file. I will go to layer, create layer, new shape file layer. So first of all I will need to give a file name with a path. I can save it to my same directory in the way I save my topo sheet. For example, I give the name locality. Then you must know that it is a point, line, or polygon. So first of all, we are creating point. We have put the coordinate reference system in 4326. That is geographic latitude, longitude. Now this section comes when you need to put the attribute data or the classification of attribute data. So as we know that this point shape file will only tell you the name of the locality. So just I can give a name, that is locality name. It can be a texture data and length. It could be 80. Add to field list. So we can see that this file has an attribute with a two field, that's ID and locality, and that in locality name. I can remove ID because I do not need this. Remove field. Okay. As we can see, a file has been created with the name of locality. Now, in order to create a data set, first of all, we need to put the editing on, that is toggle editing. And there is two methods to do that. Click on this and then click on this pencil icon, toggle editing, or you can directly right click on this and put on toggle editing on. So after creating putting toggle editing in on mode, this feature will be highlighted, and this feature is known as add point feature. I will click on this and just point out my where I want to create a point, like this is a colony known as Judge colony. So I will click on this point and give a name. Okay. Now this is known as TT Nagar. So I will put TT. You can create any point data set, and it can be what we can say that benchmarks or any number of trees or number of temples and mosques. You can create any type of data set, but in present case, for this tutorial purpose, I am just creating some few points. Now this is the point known as Secretariat. So pardon with the spelling. This is known as Arera Colony. So I think this will be enough. So I have created 4 to 5 points. In order to see that, I will just uncheck this Bhopal mosaic. So I've created 4 points, as we can see. And in order to save this edits, I need to click on this save edit layers. and by right click on this and open attribute table, I can see that total four number of points have been created. There is Secretariat, Arera Colony, Judge Colony and TT Nagar. So if you want to delete any part or any point, you just select that data. As you can see, I have selected Secretariat and this point is highlighted. I can directly delete from delete selector features. Or if you don't want to open this attribute table, you can directly click delete from this layer view panel. Just select that point and selection can be done with this rectangle feature. I have selected my this point and you can directly delete from this. And if I want to undo, I can click on Ctrl Z. So this is how I can create a point layer. Now, at the end of any editing feature, we should put this toggle editing mode off. Now this locality shape file, a point shape file, has been created permanently. So next we're going to move towards line feature, creating line feature. So before that, we can see that in our folder there is a total number of 5 files in the name of locality. So these all files are supporting of shapefile. Main file is this .shp and all other files are supporting files. So if you need to transfer, if you want to transfer that shapefile to some another body, you need to transfer all these supporting files. So moving towards line feature, I will click on layer, create layer, new shapefile, and this time I will put a name linear. Save, that will be line. And I want to create a linear file which contains roads, railways or river body or river. So I will, first of all, I will create a column name, that is field name, that is class text data 80 length, and then name. That is, I don't need this ID column, remove. Okay, as I can see, a file has been created with the name of linear. In order to put the editing mode on, I will right click on this, toggle editing, and create this icon. This means add line features. So the symbology has been changed of my cursor. That means I'm ready to digitize. In order to create line, I just clicking on points where I have to click. So due to the contrast of our topo sheet, we are unable to see the line. I'll just uncheck the topo sheet. As I can see, a line has been created with the help of dots that have been created. In order to end our line, I will just right click on this. It's asking me class, that is, I know this is a road, and name, and it could be, let's say, for example, I'm creating Arera. Okay. Just putting mode on. There is an QGIS allow us to put the snapping mode on. So in order to digitize any linear or polygon feature, we should always on the snapping features. So first of all, without enabling a snapping feature, what error can occur? So if you want to create a road, as you can see that our road is up to this point. So if you want to create a road which is continue to this road, what I will do, I will click on linear. First of all, I will just save this file and I will again on click on add line feature. The very first thing I should keep in mind is the end of this line and the end point of this line and the first point of this new line should be the same. Like if I want to create line from this point, I will just click on this and put an end to my file. Okay, but as we can zoom, this line has not been joined. So this type of error known as undershooting. And if our line crosses this line, so that means this is known as overshooting. So in order to avoid this type of error, we will use snapping option. So first of all, we will delete this line save my data. In order to enable snapping, first of all we will open the snapping toolbar. And how to enable the snapping toolbar? Right click on this blank space and click on toolbars, search on toolbar, that is snapping. So this is our snapping toolbar. So I will click on enable snapping. As you can see, all the columns have been highlighted. All layer I want to click enabling of all the layers, vertex and segment. It is up to the user that they want to enable snapping for vertex only, vertex segment and segment only. But in the present case, I will click on vertex and segment. So if I want to continue my line, draw my line feature, I will click on linear, click on add line feature, and as we can see that if I put my mouse nearby this point, a pink color square has already been developed, has been created. That means if I click on this point, my line will automatically will be continued from this end. So I have created another road. This is just a hypothetical case because the contrast doesn't allow us to see the background. This is known as road, and this could be a station road. And as I can see that if I zoom to the maximum extent, this line is correctly joined. So this is the use of snapping. So if you further exercise towards this snapping, you can learn the objective of the snapping tool and the advantages and disadvantages of increasing or decreasing this value. Now if I want to create, zoom to maximum extent, I think. So if I want to create any other line feature, like this is what you can say Western Central Railway line. So whatever I'll do, I will click on line. First of all, I will save this feature, click on line and put on add line feature. In order to put the end, I will right click on this. They are asking me class, so I know this is a rail and this is Habibganj. Okay, so a line has been created with the name of Habibganj, and this is the rail line. So we will open our attribute table to see that we total number, we have total three type of linear feature, that is road, the station road, then it is a railroad, and a railway line, that is Habibganj. So if you want to add it already, if you want to edit this linear feature, there are several methods to do that. Like one of the important method, that is this activating this vertex tool. So after clicking on this, this vertex tool has been activated, and if I put on my cursor to any linear feature, I can see there are total number of vertex and segments. And if I want to add any vertex, I just click on this plus sign, as you can see, and I can move this vertex. As you can see, a vertex has been developed, and I can just move this just by clicking on this and moving. And if I want to create a vertex between these two points, that is between two vertex, I click on this and this has been created. Now in order to trim or merge any two linear feature, I need an advanced digitizing toolbar. To activate this, I will click on right click on this blank space and click on advanced digitizing toolbar. As we can see, that toolbar has been activated, through which I can perform several editing features like merge, trim, etc. So if you want to trim this route up to this point only, means this route has this railway line has up to has ended up to this point. So I will select this linear feature, then I will select this split feature. I put a split line like a knife and I right click on it. So I can see that this feature has separated with each other. In order to have a clear vision, I will open the attribute table. I can see there is a two railway line with the name of Habibganj. One is the upper one, and the fourth one, this is one, is the lower one. So if I want to put the end only on this point, I can directly delete this part. And if I want to extend this railway line, so what I will do, first of all, I will save this my old work. I will click on linear, add line feature. I have a snapping mode on. I will click on this, right click, okay. So while opening, after opening, I can see that there is another feature has been developed with the name null, this layer, and I know that this point feature, oh sorry, this line feature and this line feature is same. So I can merge these two data set, like by selecting these two rows and click on this merge. It is asking in which feature I want to merge, so I will click rail Habibganj, okay. So I can see that, oh, I think I selected the wrong one, so I will do Control Z. I want to merge these two data set, that is railway and Habibganj. I will select these two, click on merge. It is asking me which. So I can create a new feature also with a new name, that is merge. I click OK. So I can see that this both separate these two lines have combined into one line, that is one feature. So I click open my with the name null. So I will type rail and Habibganj. So this is how we can create and edit our line data set. At the end, we need to save this data set and put the tackle motoring off. So now this is the first part in which we have discussed about the point and line feature. In the next part, we will talk about the polygon feature. Thank you.